Family that you have surrounded him with. Thank you, Lord, for his health. Thank you, Lord, for his parents. Thank you, Lord, for his church. Thank you, Lord, for his purpose. The destiny of God for his life. Lord, we rejoice with him. We rejoice with him. We rejoice with him. Lord, thank you. Thank you for this day. Thank you for this day. Thank you for years to come. Thank you, Lord, for the goodness Thank you for your mercy. Thank you for your provision. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. We give you praise. We give you praise. We give you praise. We give you praise. We exalt you. We exalt. I hear from the Lord says, do not let your heart be troubled. Do not let your heart be wearied. Put your trust in the Lord. For many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivered them. The Lord has prepared a place for you. This year of your golden jubilee, in this year of your greatness, in this year, you will amount to greatness.
Amen.
Your light will not be dwindled.
Amen.
Your light will burn more.
Amen.
Your light will attract
Amen.
Others to the Lord.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
It shall be well with you.
Amen.
It shall be well with all that connects with you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
If your heart can perceive it, your hands will achieve them.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
It shall be well with you.
Amen.
Father, we thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you for the special birthday package.
Thank you, Jesus.
For this young man. Amen. Thank you for his life.
Amen.
Thank you for the vision.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord, because you have made it happen.
Amen.
The Lord that made it, the Lord will form it.
Yes,
Lord, thank you.
Amen.
We thank you for his life.
Amen.
Just pray for him for many more years to come.
Yes.
We'll strengthen his health in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let the heaven over him not be short.
Amen.
Favor him, O God.
Amen.
We give you praise.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Congratulations.
Amen.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
He wasn't happy. He said, I don't want anyone to know. I'm just giving thanksgiving. Don't do anything. It's my birthday. So I was shocked when he said it out. I'm 58. But we thank God. It's God who did that.
Amen.
He taught his soul to save. So I want to give him praise for his body. Thank you, God. Our marriage as well. His body to be praised.
Amen. Hallelujah. You're going places.
Amen. I'm going to shock three people here with my testimony. Because I feel that sometimes when you ask God for something and he gives it to you, if you don't testify, then it means that you're not grateful. And I'm asking the church in advance to pray for lone parents raising children on their own. There's a stereotype that children from such homes will not amount to anything. I want to celebrate my children. Adana no Zamaka. I don't want to break down. I've never had meetings for them for the wrong reasons. Email came through. It happens all the time. I don't want to say I take it for granted. I thank God. But the last email was, the last school was that he's never taught any person in his how many years as a teacher. And was asking me, how are you doing it? And I always say, God. And the other email came and said also that in addition to Adana, that her younger sister, I can't wait for parents' teachers' evening. So that I can tell you what your children are doing. And when I mentioned that I was alone, I said, that even makes it greater. But they don't know what my secret weapon is the church. And those Obiechina, I mean, I've told pastor before, because you don't know what you have when you have a pastor that wants to know what happens to you when you walk out of the door. At the end of service, most times, pastor will call me and sit me down. what is happening with his school. And I tell him, you have to open up to him so that he knows how to pray. Him and Pastor Nika. Pastor Nika will wake me up and pray with me. And Obiechina, too, because I told you he was acting up. And, just acting out. And people say it's because he doesn't have a father figure. He does. Pastor is his father figure. Yeah. God is his father figure. He doesn't need any other one unless God sends one to me, actually. And the last time I went to school, Pastor Nike, the teacher just said, wait, I need to tell you something. All the calls I made to you previously have been bad ones. So now is a good call. I'm going to call you.
Yes.
He said that he's like a different person.
Yeah.
Intelligence. He's so focused on his work, he has changed.
Amen.
That he don't understand what happened. Yeah, I was laughing because me, I know it is prayer.
Amen.
So I thank God for them and I'm just celebrating them.
God has great things in store for you.
Trust in the Lord. Mm-hmm. There is no darkness. Mm-hmm. Trust in the Lord. Mm-hmm. You've been forgiven. Mm-hmm. Trust in the Lord. Mm-hmm. In your redemption. Your God, and all will be well in Him. He is the Maker, the Giver of life. Don't get the power, and in the end, you don't see your soul. See, first is the kingdom of God. Forever again. Hey, 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 now trust in the Lord, in Him. In Him, there is no darkness. In Him, trust in the Lord. In Him, you'll be forgiven. In Him, trust in the Lord.
God knows it all. That being the case, he wants you and I also to be knowledgeable about the things happening around you. There are certain things that happen around us that we don't know how to handle. We are bewildered and then amazed. What is the way forward? Well, we know that God knows it and He will direct us. In Psalm 119, verse 144, the scripture makes us understand. It reads, "Give me understanding that I shall live." You are in a puzzle. It's like a maze, a complex system of pathways. They look confusing. You are looking for a way out. He thought you are in a dreamland. And you know, you just have to keep going in your quest for an exit. Searching for how to get out of this conundrum, as it were. But you know, the world that we live, as complex as it is ruled today by those that know how. Not only know how to, but they can also show us how. And that brings me to the point that we all need insight into problems that confront us in this life. Could be from family, health, career, marriage, status. How to work out of such problems. How to find our ways through this seemingly complex pathway. And we all have to confront it. If not now, but later. For some have already gone through it. John chapter 14 verse 1. Jesus therefore said, "Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me." To his followers, Jesus spoke, because it is impossible for us not to see things in life and not be ruffled. It is impossible for us not to find ourselves in such complex situations and not be troubled. But he warned, especially to us that believe, when it's your turn, do not let your heart be troubled. How? Believe in God. Believe in His Christ. Insight, therefore, is important. The man with an insight is the one that has a sight of where he's going. Insight, according to English dictionary, if you gain insight into a problem, you actually gain an accurate and deep understanding of it. No wonder the writer said, "Give me understanding and I shall live." I pray that God will give you understanding.
Amen.
Of your own predicament.
Amen.
And you will come out of it.
Amen.
You are not living yet until you gain an accurate and deep understanding of your own life situation.
Amen.
That's why he said, "Give me so that I shall live." Because he knows the man that has understanding of his situation is the one that will stand to live. And this is why many people live to fight the same problem over and over again. Because they avoid getting understanding of their situation. And remember the saying that says, "He that runs from a fight, live to fight it again." In Proverbs chapter 2, verse 10, "When wisdom enters into your heart and knowledge is pleasant to your soul, discretion will preserve you and understanding will keep you. Insight, therefore, is important, spiritual insight into spiritual problems, or insight generally into problems that confront us. Insights have four components. I'm talking today to people that need insight, to gain insight into their life situation. Wisdom, knowledge, discretion, and understanding. Wisdom is defined as wise actions. But how do you know how to act without knowledge? Wisdom, the scripture says, is justified by all our children. Luke 7, verse 35. What does that mean? God's Word Bible translation said, yet wisdom is proved right by all its results. Unbelievers and vain people alike make fun of God's Word. Even people that come to church, some of our friends, make fun of our faith. Some don't believe the Word of God. But why would their doubt kill your belief? Wisdom, therefore, is you acting on God's Word without mixing words. And it has to come from your heart. The question is, are you wise? Because for you to have insight, you need wisdom to act wisely. Are you wise? When wisdom enters into your heart, so the heart is the seat of wisdom. How do I know you are wise? From the action that comes from your heart. When wisdom enters into your heart. And again, he says another component of insight is knowledge. He said knowledge must be pleasant. Everyone say pleasant.
Pleasant.
Knowledge must be pleasant to your soul. The people that must have insight must be people that can read to gain knowledge. We have said that about our children. They're doing very, very well at school because they can read. If you can read, you can lead. Readers are good leaders. So knowledge will be pleasant to your soul. If you are not ready to read and study, then knowledge cannot come. Knowledge is power. People who are tired of studying are tired of winning. People who lack knowledge will lack inspiration. And they will lack direction. And they will lack the drive to make progress. 2 Timothy 2:15 says, study to show yourself, thyself approved unto God, a workman that needed not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. 2 Timothy 2:15. He says, study, be diligent, be ready to read. There is no point in complaining that things are not getting better in your life if you are not ready to make a change, an amendment, amend the way, your way. Something has to shift. A man that sleeps all the time can't wonder why things are not getting better. It's clear, isn't it? Even our spiritual lives, many people just come to church. But they don't know the Bible. They don't study the Bible. And yet God says, be diligent in that translation. But the King James Bible says, study. There's a difference between study and reading. When you study, you are taking notes. You are being diligent to take notes. I kept begging people that every day be regular with your Bible study. Have a pen and a writing material. Write things down. It's important. Because to be forewarned is beforehand. Says, study to shew yourself, thyself approved unto God, a workman. God is walking through us. He said, a workman that needed not to be ashamed. If you walk, you will not be ashamed, isn't it? If you do what is right, you will not be ashamed. I pray for everyone that is that condition today. Shame will be far from you.
Amen.
A workman that needed not to be ashamed, there is nothing to be ashamed about. Just because you have not yet made it, doesn't mean you should be ashamed. You are walking towards it. I love that sister. I say, yes. They didn't know I'm a lone parent. It doesn't matter. It's the grace of God.
Amen.
It's the grace of God. Yeah, we need fathers. But there are some fathers that are not responsible, isn't it? There's a difference between a daddy and a father. See? Daddy just brought them, isn't it? The father them. So that they can go far. For God is our Father.
Amen.
Says, rightly divided the word of truth. If it is called the word of truth, how can you then believe a lie? Many of us lack motivation to read. No? We lack motivation to get knowledge. And if you lack motivation to read, then you lack motivation to lead. Because if you can read, then you can lead. We need knowledge. We need knowledgeable people to lead us. And the reason why you are getting things when you come to church, especially the Bible study, we are talking about the Bible, is because the Holy Spirit leads us. And of course, your leaders also are receiving the leadership of the Holy Spirit. And they are in a good position to tell you the word of God. Without mixing words. Knowledge, therefore, must be pleasant to you. You don't need to be begged to study the Bible. Because you are doing it for your life. If you can get the word of God into your system, then God's word will give you insight into the situation. When you study the Bible regularly, you will become knowledgeable. We say, when wisdom enters into your heart. So wisdom enters into our heart. Knowledge is what? Pleasant. Knowledge is good. Knowledge is desirable to your soul. You now say discretion will preserve you. And understanding will keep you. There's a saying that says discretion is better. Is the better part of valor. Discretion is the better part of valor. If you can avoid something dangerous from happening, this is discretion. If the sad now says, should go into the bush, or you can see that there's another road that is not leading to the bush, discretion therefore is better, is the better part of valor. That yes, I can do this. When you can see that doing that work will cost you your life. Am I seeing somebody?
Yes.
It is not discretion when you can avoid but you still decide to risk it. It's not going to be red light now. Yes, you know it's about to go to red. It's getting red. And you're coming with that speed. Not only that, there is a police car. See? You might get away with it, but thank God, one day you'll be caught. Discretion, according to the dictionary, is behaving in a way without drawing attention to yourself. Can you pick that? Behaving in such a way, in a place, without drawing attention to yourself. It is your ability to put wisdom and knowledge into work to help you do things considerably. I would say discretion is your ability to consider the feelings of others. So when wisdom enters your heart, and knowledge is pleasant to your soul, you can see how discretion will preserve one. Now it goes on to say, understanding will keep you. Understanding, therefore, is insight. Give me understanding and I shall live. Until you gain understanding, you cannot gain control. Proverbs 20, verse 5. English Standard Bible says, the purpose in a man's heart is like deep water, but a man of understanding will draw it out. The purpose in a man's heart is like deep water, but a man of understanding will draw it out. Yes, you have a purpose in life or dreams, but they remain untouched until you have insight. Does that make sense? You may have dreams, lofty dreams, but those dreams will just remain there like a picture unless you can reach out to them. And that's where insight comes in. The purpose of a man's heart is like deep water, but a man of understanding will draw it out. How many men of understanding are here today? The Lord will make you a man of understanding.
Amen.
And a woman of understanding.
Amen.
How can I get insight into this problem? Study, study, study. Gain knowledge in that particular area. Don't talk it away. Be doers of the word. Turn somebody and say, be doers of the word.
Doers of the word.
When you are at home, make effort to open the Bible. See, many of the things that we do it in secret. But we don't know that in secret lies the presence of God. So the Lord that sees in secret will reward you openly. Do you want to know your real you? You will know your real you when you are alone. I discover my real you, and I still discover my real you even up to now. In my presence, in secret places. And I spend a lot of time in secret places. In a secret place, you can hear the voice of God clear. He will tell you. You want to know the truth, he will tell you. That's how we can gain insight into that problem. Say, so let them not depart from your hearts, the word of God. Proverbs 3:21. Wisdom. Wise action. Let them not depart from your hearts. Then you will walk safely in your way. Verse 23. And your foot will not stumble. Say, your foot will not stumble.
Amen.
How? When you do not allow wisdom to depart from your eyes. And how does wisdom come? The knowledge of God. So when you study the word of God and you store it in your heart to do it, when you don't stop doing it, it says you walk safely in your way and your foot will not stumble. Even the devil knows this. And let your heart retain God's word and you shall live. Chapter 4, verse 4. Let your heart retain God's word and you shall live. Insight. All scripture is given by inspiration of God and is profitable to doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness. 2 Timothy 3:16. The knowledge of God's word is therefore profitable. The word of God is profitable. Brothers and sisters, it's not a waste of time. What is going to improve you cannot demote you. What is going to make your life better, you need to spend time with it. It will profit you if you cannot. He said, knowledge is pleasant to your soul. Let it be something not forced on you. Let it be something pleasurable to do. Especially if you find yourself in a conundrum, in a puzzle. Learn from what is written. Because God will not do outside what is written. Very quickly, let me look at an example of a man that had lacked insight. And then he got insight into his problem. 1 Samuel chapter 3. Are you ready? 1 Samuel chapter 3 verse 1. Now the boy Samuel. There's nothing wrong in you knowing God when you are a boy. Now the boy Samuel ministered to the Lord before Eli. And the word of the Lord was rare in those days. There was no widespread revelation. He didn't say there were no revelation. He says there was no widespread revelation. So some people are still getting revelation, even though it's not general. Other translation says visions were quite uncommon. He said visions were quite uncommon. So it was some people had it. Another translation says there were not many visions. And I think that one hit it by the head. Some had it. Yet God revealed himself to some people. In the same city, in the book of Amos, the rain fell on one part, and on another part, the rain did not fall. Why didn't the rain fall on some part? Why did it fall on some part? That's the question. God is in the house. Why will God reveal himself to some people, and God will not reveal himself to some people? That is the question. A man of understanding is the one that will draw. That will draw from that well of resource. God revealed himself to some people. Why can't it be you? Is that a good question? Insight. Verse 3. And before the lamp of God went out, that is before switching off the lamp of God. Even in the olden days, they knew how to switch off the lamp. They knew how to be energy savvy. How much more today? Am I talking to somebody? And while Samuel was lying down, verse 4, that the Lord called Samuel and he answered, "Here I am." Verse 5. So he ran to Eli and said, "Here I am, for you called me." And he said, "I did not call. Lie down again." And he went and lay down. Are you following me? We all need to hear from God, don't we? You want to hear from God? We all need to hear from God, especially in difficulties. We all need to hear from God when we do not know what to do. When we find ourselves in a maze or a puzzle, we all need to hear from God. How do you then desire to hear from God? Because unless you desire to hear from God, you will not hear from God. So how do you desire to hear from God? Study, study, study. knowledge will be pleasant to your soul. Remember, the word of God is the plan of what God will do. And God will not do outside his plan. Because God is a God of law and order. Study that Bible regularly and attentively. You see, when some people are studying the Bible, the mobile phone is just there by their side. If God knows if you are attentive or not, you see, I used to find my children in the sense that when they are studying, you see the mobile phone there, you see the music there. I said, how can I be studying? I said, do what I'm doing. I said, that is you, Daddy. See, how can you be studying and you have your mobile phone there and music? Or I studying changed now. I don't know. The way I was brought up to study is to concentrate, isn't it? But then you see them, the music is there, this one is there. I don't know, because your mind cannot be distracted when you are studying. So please, children, or even adults, let's study properly. Because the way you are saying you are studying shows if you are really attentive to hear from God. So take that mobile phone away, switch off the TV, at least for the next 1 hour, see how it feels to study. You can't miss anything when you do that, because you are paying attention. But when the music is there, and the social media is there, somebody will drop what, especially the other one, WhatsApp. That one, okay, you see that one. And you are still studying. That's not right. That's not right. So we all need to hear from God in our difficulties. If you are really in soup, you are in a difficult situation, your heart is open to God. Lord, speak to me. You want to hear from God. And you stay in that quiet place. Then in quietness and confidence shall you be saved. A returning and rest shall be your strength. So stay in that quiet place alone with God and see how it feels. If you don't have the luxury of other rooms, you can do it while other people are sleeping. Yeah. Okay? Insight. Are you still following?
Yes.
So God called Samuel while others were not there. Verse 6. And that's why it is important for us to have a space for God. See? Then the Lord called yet again, Samuel. So Samuel arose and went to Eli and said, here I am, for you call me. And he answered, I do not call my son, lie down again. Samuel did hear a voice, didn't he? But the only thing that Samuel did not do was to recognize whose voice it was. So it's possible for God to speak to us unless we are trained to recognize that voice. We might not know whose voice it is. And that's the more reason we need a mentor over our lives. Someone you can approach frequently for guidance. And do you have a mentor? How close are you to those mentors or to that mentor? Verse 7. Now Samuel did not yet know the Lord, nor was the word of the Lord revealed to him. You two might be coming to church, yet do not know the word of God. Yes, it's possible. Remember, this man was a boy, Samuel, who was just being brought up to the house of Eli. But we can generalize it, and it's possible to be in God's presence and yet not know that God is there. But if you are in that sort of person that you are in the church but you still don't know the voice of God, I think you are in the right place. Isn't it? You're in the right place. Verse 8. And the Lord called Samuel again. How many times?
The third time.
The third time. Thank God for God that doesn't give up on us. Even when we miss it. God called Samuel to talk time. God did not give up on people. He doesn't. So he will not give up on
you.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Because God is there with you. Even in that situation. So do you need insight there? In that situation? How do you get the insight? Study, study, study. Study, study, study. In that area that you are deficient, let's say spiritually, so you study the Bible. And stay attentive to hear what he will say to you. Habakkuk said, I'll watch to hear what he will say to you. And God is still speaking. So he arose, Samuel, and went to Eli and said, here I am. For you did call me. Did you see that? It was certain, but it was certainly wrong. And God knows. We might be certain at times, but we are certainly wrong. It is called presumption. And if you presume that something is the case, you think it is the case, but you are not sure. That's what it means, isn't it? And that gets one into trouble. To presume that God wants you to do something which you are not sure about. But to presume that God has spoken and you went ahead even though you are not sure about. My word, my instruction, my advice is that don't do anything for God when you are not sure about. Don't do anything that you are not sure about. Presumption to do something for God is a sin. Especially doing things to boost your own ego. Are you with me? When you are not certain it is the right thing to do. For this reason, God rejected King Saul. Remember? He presumed, 1 Samuel chapter 15, he presumed that God would understand. And the scripture says in verse 23, in that 1 Samuel 15, for rebellion is as a sin of divination and presumption. Is as iniquity and adoration. So if you are honest, you will not only hear from God, you will recognize his voice. So back to that 1 Samuel 3. So Eli therefore, in verse 8, perceived that the Lord had called the boy. Because if it's that important to you, it's important to God. And God will not mix his word. He wants to get it right. And that's the reason why God kept coming back. But thank God for Samuel. He also kept going back. Then Eli perceived that the Lord had called the boy. And that is the reason why you don't forsake spiritual protection to advance you in life. Verse 9. Therefore, Eli said to Samuel, go lie down, and it shall be if he calls you. Even Eli did not know whether God will call Samuel again or not. He said, if he calls you, no one knows if God will speak, but you will know when he speaks. Did you get it? If you are listening. If he calls you, then you must say, speak, Lord, for your servant hears. Thank God for Samuel. He had a teachable spirit, didn't he? Samuel was teachable. The question again, second one is, how teachable are you? Because you really want this insight badly. And yet, God is in the house. God will now tell you how to give insight and how to walk you out of the problem. Are you teachable? Only those who are ready to be taught can teach. Isn't it? How can you teach people if you have not been taught? Because people that teach what they have not been taught, they are presuming. And presumption is sin. And people can only teach what they have been taught. That is why you need to gain the knowledge. Amen.
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 Those children will grow up to be taught what their mom has taught them.
Amen.
That's it. They will be taught. They have been taught. So thank God for parents that got it right in the first place to be able to teach us. And thank God for the child that has a parent or parents teaching them. And he must be ready to be taught. Verse 10, I'm rounding up. Now the Lord came and stood and called as at other times. So God has a pattern. God is predictable. As at other times. So God knows you are supposed to be in the house today. And he's here.
Amen.
Now, what if you are not here? Then you will be doing something spiritual wherever you are. Now the Lord came and stood and called as at other times. Samuel, Samuel. And Samuel answered, speak, for your servant hears. He has learned his lesson. Because he has been taught. And he received the teaching. You not miss God's call.
Amen.
Especially in the day of visitation.
Amen.
But something that stood out here is that despite the three misses, he got the fourth right. I want us to pray, therefore. Maybe you have missed on the day of his visitation. And you wish that thing would come back. Your prayer has been answered.
Amen.
I want to pray whatever you have missed, that God will come back.
Amen.
I want to pray that you will not miss God when he comes. It is time to pray. The message has finished now. May you never miss the day of God's visitation. And whatever you have missed, pray that God will come back. And when he comes back, may you never miss God's call. Just like Samuel did, but God gave him another chance. I want to pray that God will give you another chance for you to have insight into this problem. God does not delight in you perishing in the problem. God does not delight in you staying longer than desire in that situation. But God speaks and he wants you to hear. I want to pray that God will give you the grace to be attentive. Grace to be attentive. To hear. And when he calls. And when he calls you, you too will do as Samuel did. You will answer him. Lord, speak for the servant. Hear it. Lord, thank you. Thank you for the insight. Thank you for the way out of the problem. We can see the solution right now. Walk us through. Take us through to that solution. Lord, help us, oh God, to finish well. Give us the grace to finish well. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
If you have received something, can you just give Jesus a round of applause? Amen. Thank you.